Hello Ashish, good evening. So it started raining here. अभी 15 minutes पहले से ही यहाँ पर बहुत सारी बारिश और light और ये सब disconnection.
बारिश अच्छी होती है, बड़ा अच्छा लगता है नहाने में. मैं वेट करते रहता हूँ बारिश अच्छी हो, बारिश अच्छी हो.
So welcome, welcome. I think we can start. So it's symbols, like I think the main point for me is not that what stands for what, because I feel if say suppose I say carrot, I say pen, anything like any so like, but what is pen in your reference, in Ashish reference point? मतलब आशीष के लिए पेन क्या स्टैंड करता है, इसको समझने के लिए बहुत कुछ समझना पड़ता है. इसके लिए एक ग्लोबल सिंबल हो सकता है. आई फील लाइक एवरी सिंबल इज लाइक वन, वी कैन से लाइक अ ग्लोबल सिंबल, देन वन से नेशनल सिंबल, लेट्स से ओनली थ्री कैटेगरीज, एंड देन वन पर्सनल. In the national, I'm putting in the society he is born, the age he is, and whatever experiences he has through the society, family. And then the third part is it is personal. So, एक को हम लोग पूरा मतलब global scenario ले सकते हैं, और एक को middle level और एक को personal level. तो मैं इसके लिए भी बोल रही हूँ, आज एक word है जैसे I am happy and gay. In if some poet said it in 17th century, he meant something. Now if I say I'm happy and gay, I may mean something different. So a pen for me may mean something because maybe somebody gifted me a pen, and then for me pen is something, a symbol of love, affection, and that person told me to write. But for you it may be something else. इसके लिए सिंबल का जो एक यूनिवर्सल मीनिंग है, मेरे को नहीं लगता है कि यूनिवर्सल मीनिंग हो सकता है, स्पेशली जब हम लोग एक स्पिरिचुअलिटी के रेल में करते हैं तो.
हाँ, एक आर्कटाइप टाइप की चीज होती है, क्लोजली मुझे थोड़ा सा वो लग रहा है.
आर्कटाइप हो गया उसमें.
आर्कटाइप
एंड वाई, बट वाई इज इट important to understand symbology is that we get information not in words, not in written words, we get it through symbols. That's why understanding and making a symbol dictionary is very important for oneself in the spiritual journey, because you, your spirit guides, your whatever higher self will tell you in the things that you can understand. So for you, just अभी आपने बोला ना बारिश हो जाए तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है, मैं वेट करता हूँ. मुझे उसी से ये सब समझ में आया कि बट फॉर आशीष इफ से सपोज यू क्लोज योर आईज और समथिंग ऑफ रेन कम्स, देन यू हैव दिस पर्सनल कनेक्शन दैट आई वेट फॉर दिस एंड व्हेन इट हैपेंस इट विल मेक मी हैप्पी. तो उस तरह से सिंबल कोई भी चीज का, एनिमल का, हम लोग इक्वल टू how to interpret the experiences which are invisible, which are not sensed by the five senses, how to interpret them. It could be dream symbology. It could be the images you see in the meditation. It could be anything that appears to be a message for you.
That just like in my context was like flying. So flying was like my personal context. If flying in general means different thing. It can mean freedom. It can mean escape. It can mean like power, dominance. It can mean like higher perspective.
So that's why, and I definitely like this point that every time we see flying, it may not be the same. Because sometime it could be like, I want to be a Superman. Sometime it could be like, I want to connect with knowledge, which is not easily reachable. And sometimes it is that I don't want to be where I am right now physically, but I want to be in some different part. It could mean so many things, the same thing. So you have to be really aware of the mood in which you see the symbol, the feeling with which you see the symbol, what questions you had asked prior to seeing that thing, what were you reading, what was your state of mind, what did your friend tell you, what did your mother tell you, what did you watch in television. Everything will matter if you are just interpreting one symbol. So Sunita is a very dear friend of mine. She lives in Bangalore and is a spiritual student, I can say. Well, very much into, please tell something about yourself, Sunita. What do you do exactly? So Sunita, something, two words about yourself, please.
Yeah, I, as you know already, Anuradha ji, I'm into Reiki.
Yeah.
From the last 10 years.
And you are based in Bangalore?
Right.
Right. And do you do online sessions also? Like it, remotely Reiki can be done, or people have to visit you?
Actually, Reiki can be done, distant healing also. It is possible. So you can do it online also. Yeah.
So in Reiki also symbols play an important role, right?
Yes, very much, very much. Yeah. We have, it's Reiki actually has the Japanese symbols, basically.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. So that is what they are. But they are extremely powerful symbols. Even in distant healing, when you send them, they really are wonderful, you know.
Yeah, I tried Reiki level 2, but I am like quite satisfied with Reiki level 1. Sometimes I
do it. I am aware,
I'm aware of some symbol like Chokure, Honsha, Din.
Honsha Zeshunen, yes. Yeah, that is a distance symbol basically.
Yeah. But my Reiki session like mostly on and off kind of.
It depends on what you like. Basically, so what are you into basically then?
So regarding spiritual journey.
Yes, what are you into?
Like I mostly do meditate or presently I am like focusing on intuitive thing.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah. Intuition and clairvoyance basically. That's,
yes.
Okay, yeah. So that is third eye.
Yes.
Once again, yeah.
And I try, like, I also try, like, various experiments. I like to try various experiments on spiritual things.
Nice. Very like sometime, nice.
Sometimes we do, like, how can in us one, like, experience, meditative experience, or, like, how can you better go to relaxing mode, and how can you entire, like, holistically, how can you improve your, like, physical and mental well-being?
It's wonderful.
Be it exercise, be it, like, meditation, alternate healing therapy, essential oil, and many other things. So bits and pieces of many things.
Okay. Very nice. I'm also into intuition and Reiki, basically.
Yeah.
That's my,
Because intuition is a very powerful thing. Once you can figure it out, like how to navigate your path, then it's like nothing better than that.
Yeah, that is true. So, Anuradha ji is also a wonderful friend. Came across her during one of her.
Your video is going on and off. And that's
Sorry. Battery is a little.
Do you have any view on symbols? Like, do you think there are universal symbols or personal symbols? Personal dictionary is important.
Yes, I do feel like, you know, sometimes we see birds or butterflies and you feel it's something, you know, something very different, like, you know, different things, like you just feel different energies when you see things like that. So or you see feathers.
Yeah,
that kind of a thing. Yeah.
And today I just like I want.
But to... I don't know about the interpretation of symbols. I haven't really gone into that. But I just feel that like their nature keeps giving us different. You know, like you see the birds, the butterflies. Each thing has a different meaning. I think you know. Only when we go deeper into it.
What I was sharing with Ashish when you were just joining was that a spiritual student or a spiritual scientist needs to create a dictionary of his or her own. Like when I see feather, what it means.
What does it mean? Yeah.
But today says the 3rd of July, it could mean something because I asked a question of something. So feather could mean something else. And on say 5th of August, a feather could mean different things. So we have to be, you know, so we have to do a 360 angle analysis of it before interpreting any symbol. That's what I'm getting at. So, so even a feather, so the best thing to start with is that, you know, you just start conversing with the feather. That what is the message, feather, dear feather, dear butterfly, this butterfly. And you know, like you will feel like I will feel that okay, this answers are coming from me only, and that's how we start by imagining. Everything in spirituality is like by imagining, but then you get into things like when you ask more and more questions. Okay, so what does this mean? So what does that mean? What does this mean? So that's how we progress. You know, it could be a symbol, it could be a question, who am I? Like it is said about Ramana Maharishi that he just kept on asking, who am I? Who am I? Kept on meditating on that question for years and years together. And I am not sure about Buddhaji, but he also like relentless meditation only on one question or only on one concept. And you just build it up, build the awareness of it. And through maybe books, through meditation, through teachers, through people speaking to you, answers come in.
Just flow, okay.
Flow. And to expect that the answers will flow in a day or 2 days is not the thing. It will flow in some time.
Over a period of time.
Yeah, and then you will get to know, okay, a feather, today it means this. Or if you are doing it for a friend, then also you will, you know, ask so many questions. So what did you, when did you see feather last? Something, you know, you will ask 10 questions before interpreting that feather for a friend or a client. Because you have done it, you have asked yourself 100 questions already.
Yeah, that's there. But you know what, Anuradhaji, sometimes when you ask the question and you get the answer, so you're not sure whether you're hearing it or is it like, you know, or you're just imagining it, you know, sometimes happens like, you know, you're not sure whether, you know, what is that?
It always happens that way, that you're not sure.
Yeah.
But when you're not sure, then you have to ask more questions about it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my way of saying. Or... you know, for today, this is the answer, you could say.
Okay.
For fine. Now, this
for
is
tomorrow,
the
it may be, yeah, yeah. For tomorrow, it may be a different answer. That's what we are saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because tomorrow, your knowledge, your wisdom, or your experience
will grow,
will be different, will be wide, will be different.
Yes. Correct. Yeah.
So, but... once you start observing, it's like, you know, you get an eye or you get that kind of a neuron connection for a symbol.
Okay.
Then something is triggered in you and then your dictionary or your glossary, your personal glossary will expand.
Okay.
That's why...
Very interesting.
That's why dreams, to write down dreams is important. That's
very
That's why to write those experiences of meditation is important. That's why to write a personal diary is important. It's not important that you what you write after say 5 years. You have to just compile it and see that what is my learning from these two diaries.
Okay.
just go through
from
them
the past and the, yeah.
And then you will understand, oh, I was going through this, I was going through this, this meant this. Because, you know, hindsight is what 2020 is, hindsight something. when you see today, from today, you read your 2 years back dictionary.
Correct.
You will exactly know what, how it rolled, what it meant.
And you find that you have different experiences and you have grown in a different way also. You'll find that growth experience also, that, you know, things have changed over a period of time. Things have matured in a different manner, I guess, like, you know, when we go about it. Yeah. I think, no, over the period of time, you'll feel it. Yes. Yeah.
So one of my meditation teachers right now I'm following, he told me, so how many diaries have you written? Just like I have met him 5 months.
Right.
Back. So I said 5-6 diaries in 10 years, like this thick diary. So now he says, now it is time for you to go through it and just say, what is my learning? It's not word by word, just feel it. What is my learning?
Okay.
From say 2003 diary, 2003 May diary.
Okay.
Just feel it. Just read it, feel it. And then make... Okay. Like from 3 diaries, make half diary. You know, that's how you create a knowledge base. Of course, not for yourself, you know, a selfish way, but then it is
to help others also.
Universal knowledge.
To help others.
Knowledge base.
Yes.
So something is that you are doing reading and you are materializing and bringing it physically, but it is, you know, it is for everybody.
Yeah. Everyone's benefit.
So that is much for symbology. Now today I don't know, but why I want to also, you know, share about that other than symbols, these websites and these online platforms have now become portals of information, of energy. And I just want to give you this idea, if you already don't know, that certain websites or certain say teachers, when you see their video, they may be speaking of different topic, but something hits you, like, you know, or something opens up for you. And so even those videos,
it's something you may be searching for and you get the answer suddenly. That's what you're saying, right?
It is not what I'm getting at is that even because in this era, in this world where we live in, even the apps, portals, websites, videos are messages, messaging systems on giving us messages.
Okay.
And one of the teachers I've been following for about 15 years is Denise Lynn. I just want to share her portal right now here.
Sure.
Just a moment, give me a time. And she says that I have created this portal for you to give energy, to give you energy. I send energy through this portal. Now, whether you believe that or not, but this is her way of, you know, spreading her energy and giving her energy to all of us.
Okay.
And sometimes when I feel sick or something, you know, I do go to these portals and they have made a huge difference for me. So I want to share this. Share my screen. Can you see my screen?
Yeah, it's coming.
Yes.
So I have done many courses. Denise Lynn, I can also put it in the chat. DeniseLynn.com is the healing portal. And she says, I energize this portal on a daily basis. And if you feel like to receive energy, like look at the chart, she has written it also. Visualize waves coming towards you. As you do this, know that a shimmering life force from whatever, like you can read it.
Yes.
Yeah. And so it's not only those, you know, like physical statues or physical temples that you build and receive and create energies. But now, physical portals have also, you know, have that potential to give you those things. Now, if you go to her homepage, you will have chakras. Every chakra also, she has created these portals. And like, you know, 10 years back, she has created, at least I came to know 10 years back. So this is how teachers are, you know, doing it right now. So physical symbols were always there. But now this digital kind of signals, symbols, also portals are there and very much present. At least when I don't have not been visiting this website for quite some time. But when I initially, I really felt a lot of support with this website.
Oh,
you know, just sit staring at it and feel that something is like, you know, coming to you. And then she says, once you have those energies, also, you know, like reciprocate, give your energies to people around. And so this is one thing that
That's wonderful. Really nice.
So that much about the symbol thing. And this, I really don't want to go into the glossary of, you know, parrot means this, crocodile means this, because it is just it is personalized.
There is one interesting book I came across, like the book name is Einstein Factor.
Okay.
Like it was suggested in one of the remote viewing lecture. So I like this book, and in first two chapter there are two concepts. One is like image streaming is very much similar to the like other thing you are saying. Like suppose if you are seeing some feather, okay, then what's adjacent to it, what's just above of it, what's the color of it, and why you are here. So like asking many of the questions, just like in remote viewing, you ask for like what's the color, temperature, density, and various other factor, like maybe and extra like where are you, like you are on the ground, you are on some height. So these are type of questions that are mentioned there. And second chapter is like the portable memory bank, the same thing like journaling. So there they give the example of like Einstein, Michael Faraday. He was like a very much good in, even Einstein was very much good in image streaming. So like theory of relativity and all this thing didn't came from like integration, differentiation and mathematical sense of thing. Like presently Einstein is associated with the intelligence, but it's not the intelligence, it's much beyond than that. He used to thought experiment with the thing, like what happens if I am sitting on a light beam, what I will see around, what like what's the experience, and I'm sitting on light beam and like I'm walking, I'm traveling, so in that case my speed will increase greater than light, so like what will happen. So he was like perfect image streamer. So all this thing he kind of like asked in the images, like what will happen this and what will happen this. So for the relativity theory, he continued to experiment for more than 10 years. Then the equation was like a part of thing where he already got the answer, like what happens with light and you're traveling with light and the space time curve. He already got the answer, but to put in the mathematical terms, it took time. So already answers he got. So it was like a process of image streaming. Even for the Faraday used to take his like notebook everywhere he used to go, then writing the random thing. If he's seeing rainbow, okay, rainbow, what's the color of it, size, shape, and everything. So Faraday was like, we consider him a scientist, but he was more of like enthusiast, curious kind of being. However, he lacked academic knowledge, mathematical knowledge of that time. He was very poor and no academic knowledge, but he gave us the thing like present day motor, transformer, everything. So without him, like we will not be talking, because he gave so much of the thing. And the answer came from like images, in form of images, image streaming, and experiment on the same thing again and again, like what will happen, asking the same question again and again, and journaling, the portable memory bank. There is a concept that is portable memory bank.
Wonderful.
It's wonderful. Sunita, we can't see your video.
Yeah, I'll just put it on.
So wonderful. Ashish, can you put the whatever that book or something on the chat.
If you can. Yes. I like that book, but that book I have in like from like 2-3 years back. 2 years back, I bought it. Then I read it like, wow, it's very interesting concept. Then I forgot it.
Yeah.
The Einstein factor.
Einstein factor. Okay.
Yeah, Einstein factor.
Okay, now I'll remember Einstein factor.
Einstein factor.
Wonderful.
So basically was like in line of attempt, like asking question, getting answer, and broader categories like intuitive and images and symbol kind of thing.
Yeah, but they say that people like Einstein and all, they used to use a lot of their brain, you know. I don't know, they say something about that, like they say, I think compared to a normal human being, they used to use more of their, I don't know, left hemisphere, right hemisphere, I'm not too sure about that.
It is said, but he also have one other case, like you may heard of Nikola Tesla.
Tesla is a very famous scientist.
Very famous scientist. He gave us the alternating current. So because of him, we are enjoying this chat. So like, he was so good in visualization, he can create a motor and everything without, in his mind. A real innovation, completely in his mind. So something that world has not seen yet, he has created in his mind. Then he can like ask for capitalist, okay, I can build you that sort of machine.
Exactly.
And in his mind, like it was so like accurate. If something is not going well, something was not going right, in his mind, his thought experiment, he calculated, okay, that thing will not work right.
Right. Before it even comes into the physical reality, I think they already have imagined it in the unknown, the unknown realm.
Unknown. So it is like more, it is not like of intelligence and brain person, it is more of like,
it is intuitive,
images, intuitive psychic field.
That is true. What you're saying.
I'm great
very
fan
much.
Of him because
I'm very fond of Nikola Tesla.
You might like the movie The Current Force.
Is it? I haven't seen it. Okay. And there is another
thing. AC and DC thing back in 1890s or 1880s.
Theory which says something about numbers of him, his, that 369. How to, 369 technique. Exactly. The 369 technique. Exactly. Supposed to be very, very, very good. Supposed to, you can manifest anything with it. Supposedly they say, I haven't really used the technique, but I've heard a lot about it.
He used to do this technique very much. Like something must be done in that way, like house or whether he's something is constructing. There must be some pattern that is aligned with this numerology. But this kind of genius ability, I'm like really great fan of. Something in mind that don't yet exist and calculating every bit of it.
Exactly. So I guess those people used to go more into the unknown realm and then bring it into the physical reality.
And one more important thing in the Nikola Tesla family, like from the birth, they focus, their family focus more of like visual thing, like visualizing the thing, visualizing the problem in mind.
Yeah.
And one other book I have read, like it's by Sonia Schockett, Trusting Your Vibes. It is a very good book about intuition.
Okay.
So in her family too, she was from like Europe, and her family has seen the Holocaust days, like her mother or father. So her mother, initially from the childhood time, she tells like, don't follow the external thing, don't follow the whatever world is telling you, follow the heart, follow the intuition. So they force their child from the childhood time to follow the intuition. Okay. And her mother was survived by her intuitive ability also.
In one instance,
she mentioned like there was a train going to Auschwitz. Auschwitz was like very infamous place in Holocaust time. Went there, you will never come back.
Okay.
So one of the intuition hunches of her mother, like jump off the train, right now. So it jump off the train, which was going to that concentration camp, and then she managed to survive and came. Then her family shifted to, I think, US.
Yeah, wonderful. That's what I'm saying. We should follow our intuition, because it's very important. So many times we don't listen to our intuition, and then, you know, we see that exactly the same thing which we have been told actually occurs in front of us, and then we repent and say, oh, we should have followed it, you know, at times. Yeah, it's important.
Even Einstein family, like Einstein was like slow learner, so not much attention is paid to him, and meanwhile he got the time. In his childhood time, like, there was some guy who used to teach him physics or math, and since he was a slow learner, he has all of his time like practicing the thing, delving into curiosity, and he has all of the time to practice all this thing and explore the full realm of intuitive ability.
Yeah, exactly. Lovely.
So somehow all this thing started from the childhood.
Right. Yeah. Okay,
back somehow to the dots of
where is she?
From the, we are connecting the dots from spirituality to symbols, to science symbols, to creating invention, and then Sonia Shikhet.
Everything is connected, I guess.
Everything is connected. That's why all this conversation is making so much sense, and Ashish brings up so much to the conversation. And Sonia Shikhet, I had just forgotten. I have read this book of hers.
Trusting your vibes
is what Sunita ji was asking earlier, that how do we trust?
Experiment
and trust.
Yes,
you build the trust. Trusting your vibes. The same thing, like trusting your symbol dictionary, trusting your experience, trusting your intuitive power.
Hi, both.
Hello, both.
Yes, sir.
Hi. Welcome.
Oh, he's joined us.
Welcome, both.
Can't see him.
Thank you.
If you are on your video, you have to scroll. Because only three people, or sometimes only two people, are visible on a phone.
Yes. Yes, madam. Asta, bilkul white lag rahe ho.
किसी का कोविड, किसी के बच्चों का कुछ, किसी का हस्बैंड का कुछ, तो I'm really happy about rains. Yeah, actually, symbols का conversation हो गया, लेकिन but if something आपके दिमाग में कुछ आया है, या because आप आखरी में आए तो.
इसमें क्या होता है कि अगमा पद्धति के अनुसार देवी पांच सतह के आसन पर विद्यमान होती है. उसमें पहली सतह होती है कछुआ, tortoise. क्या हुआ? ये क्या हुआ?
बोलिए. Like something.
ये वाला हो गया क्या?
नहीं नहीं सिंपल.
अच्छा, okay. तो सबसे पहली लेयर होती है वो टॉर्टाइज की होती है. टॉर्टाइज स्थिरता का प्रतीक है, स्टेबिलिटी. लेकिन केवल स्थिरता पर्याप्त नहीं है, तो दूसरी सतह होती है सांप की. सांप शालीनता का प्रतीक है. आप क्या लिख रहे हो क्या?
हाँ, अगमा देवी के
अगमा पद्धति के अनुसार.
हाँ, अगमा देवी पद्धति.
लेकिन केवल शालीनता पर्याप्त नहीं है, तो उसके बाद थर्ड सतह होती है शेर की, सिंह की. ये मैं आपको लिख के दे दूंगा. वैसे ये पद्म साधना में होता है वैसे. तो सिंह जो है वो जागरूकता का प्रतीक होता है.
ओके.
और ये भी पर्याप्त नहीं है, तो इसके ऊपर होता है सिद्ध पुरुष. सिद्ध पुरुष जो है परिपूर्णता का प्रतीक है, और परिपूर्णता भी पर्याप्त नहीं है, तो लास्ट की जो सतह होती है वो कमल के फूल की होती है. कमल का फूल प्रफुल्लता का प्रतीक है, जॉय, ब्लिस. तो जब हमारी साधना में ये पांच गुण होते हैं, स्थिरता, शालीनता, जागरूकता, परिपूर्णता और प्रफुल्लता, तो देवी, तो मतलब, तो क्या होता है, हाँ, तो दिव्य ऊर्जा प्रकाशित होती है. ये है। तो सिंबॉलिज्म में ये जो पांच मैंने बताया ना, ये इनका अगर आप किसी टेम्पल में जाओगे और आपको ये दिखेंगे तो ये उनका सिंबॉलिक मीनिंग है ऐसे। और एक और है कि साउथ का, हाँ क्या क्या कह रहे हो,
मतलब ये किसका कोई कोई किसका कंटेक्स्ट रिलेटेड था ये, कोई
सिंबॉलिज्म है? मैंने ये बताया था कि अगमा पद्धति होती है,
कॉन्शियस अगमा
पद्धति, ये क्या होता है? हाँ, एक अगमा पद्धति होती है, देवी जो होती है ना, जो भी आप बोलते हो देवी बोलते हो या क्या बोलते एनलाइटनमेंट बोलते हो, तो हमारे व्यक्तित्व में ये पांच चीजें होनी चाहिए, पांच। तो जब ये पांच होती है, लाइक अगर आप गौतम बुद्धा को भी देखोगे तो उनके अंदर ये पांच गुण थे, स्थिरता, शालीनता, जागरूकता, परिपूर्णता और प्रफुल्लता, तब एनलाइटनमेंट होती है। तो ये चाहो तो आप मेडिटेशन से ला सकते हो, चाहो तो आप बाय कॉन्शियसनेस अवेयर रहके आप कर सकते हो। और साउथ के टेंपल्स में आप जाओगे, आई थिंक कोणार्क है या पता नहीं कौन सा टेंपल था, जहां पे रिवर ही होती है, जनरली टेंपल्स रिवर के पास ही होते हैं, लेकिन जहां रिवर नहीं होती वहां पर एक टेंपल देखा था मैंने, उसके दरवाजे पे कछुआ और मगरमच्छ, आई थिंक कछुआ और सांप थे, मुझे एग्जैक्ट दो दो जानवर थे, उन्होंने दरवाजे पर एक साइड और एक साइड बना रखे थे। तो उसमें से कछुआ जो है वो गंगा का प्रतीक है और मगरमच्छ शायद यमुना का प्रतीक है। तो क्योंकि वहां रिवर नहीं थी उसके पास, तो उन्होंने ये दोनों जानवर के बनाए हुए हैं। तो इनका रिवर के उसमें भी टेम्पल आर्किटेक्चर में भी सिम्बोलिज है इसमें। बाकी सिम्बोलिज्म में और भी चीजें आती हैं, सीमियोटिक्स आता है, सीमेंटिक्स आता है, साइंस बहुत वास्ट है वो, तो फिर मतलब ए बी सी डी ये सारे सिंबल्स हैं, फिर जो हम ट्रैफिक लाइट पे हम देखते हैं वो सारे सिंबल्स हैं, वो मतलब मुझे उतना नहीं आता, लेकिन ये सब सिंबल, हाँ लेकिन ये सब कुछ लैंग्वेज से आते हैं, लाइक इनका सीमियोटिक्स का लैंग्वेज लिंग्विस्टिक्स से भी कुछ रिलेशनशिप है, मुझे उतना डीप नहीं पता, मुझे बहुत सुपरफिशियल लेवल पर ऊपर ऊपर पता है। और लिंग्विस्टिक्स में जैक्स जैक्स डारिडा ने काफी काम किया हुआ है, तो उनकी एक बुक है पता नहीं लैंग्वेज पैटर्न या पता नहीं कौन सी, जो काफी फेमस बुक,
लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग
पता नहीं लैंग्वेज पैटर्न है मेरे ख्याल से, जैक्स डारिडा की, ही इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी ए गुरु गुरु मास्टर इन लिंग्विस्टिक्स, जैक्स डारिडा। और मुझे कहीं ना कहीं ऐसा लगता है कि जो हमारे एंशिएंट लिपि हुई है, द्रविड़ियन स्टाइल वगैरह जो भी है, वो सब भी मतलब सिंबॉलिज्म से प्रेरित है। मतलब जैसे अगर हम हिंदी में देखें र को ऐसे लिखते हैं, ऐसे करके लिखते हैं र, ऐसे करके ना, और अगर आप अपने लंग इसका जीभ का ट्विस्ट देंगे र बोलते समय र, तो वो भी ऐसे टर्न करता है। तो जितने भी हमारे अल्फाबेट्स हैं हिंदी के, क ख ग घ, वो कहीं ना कहीं आपका जो टंग का मूवमेंट होता है, जब उसका जो शेप बनता है उससे लिए गए, क ख ग घ ऐसे करके, र का तो मुझे पता है, मतलब इट्स वेरी डीप, आई मुझे उतना नॉलेज नहीं है, मुझे थोड़ा ही पता है।
ये काइंड ऑफ सोसाइटल सिंबल टाइप का जैसे हो गए, जैसे मैम बता रही थी शुरुआत में एक बार अभी।